So, you bought a used OEM small form factor system, and it's an excellent home server, obviously, but have since discovered that the stock CPU cooler leaves a lot to be desired? Well, today we're going to be installing a Noctua NH-L9i in this HP Elitedesk 800 G3 small form factor and doing a thermal comparison to see how good of an upgrade it is. First, we'll go over how to install the Noctua cooler because it requires a minor modification to the case. My system is a HP Elitedesk 800 G3 small form factor, which I can of course confirm fits this cooler fine, but it may not be compatible with other systems depending on the motherboard and the case. The first generation Elitedesk small form factor, for example, doesn't use a standard screw hole layout for the cooler. You also may find that some systems aren't as easily compatible if they don't have a standard 4-pin PWM fan connector like this Elitedesk does. Another thing to note is that the NH-L9i fits because instead of a backplate, it uses 4 thumb screws for mounting. That's important because there's a raised section of the case behind the stock Intel backplate that would also need to be modified to fit a standard cooler. Now for the installation. Start by opening the system and then removing the CPU cooler shroud and disconnect the power cables from the board. We won't be reusing the shroud because of the significant height and shape difference between the coolers. Now we can unscrew the stock heatsink. The main issue preventing us from installing an aftermarket cooler is that the stock heatsink screws into the back of the case, rather than the motherboard backplate. While I can tolerate many of HP's strange design choices because of how cheap these systems are, this isn't one I understand, let alone am willing to just put up with. Fortunately, there is a way to fix it. We need to remove the motherboard from the case to access the standoffs, as well as the power supply to give us more room to work. We can see the extent of the issue with the motherboard removed, since there's 4 standoffs that need to be hammered down. To do that, I took a screwdriver and hit it with a hammer to flatten them. While in the footage on screen I started with a Phillips screwdriver, I ended up using a much larger flat screwdriver and also not doing the work on my table. This modification isn't exactly reversible, so be careful when doing it. Now, back with the motherboard, it's a fairly standard cooler install since, other than the weird case standoffs, it isn't too different from regular motherboards, at least in terms of the CPU socket. Basically, the screw holes are in the right place on this model. There is one important thing to keep in mind, that the NH-L9i must be installed with the Noctua logo on the side of the heatsink facing towards the PCIe slots, not towards the back or front of the case. Otherwise, you risk crushing a capacitor on the motherboard that's just slightly too close to the leg of the cooler when it's turned 90 degrees. I discovered another fairly substantial issue with this system once I fully disassembled it, and I'm fairly certain it's because HP cheaped out on the motherboard, at least in terms of rigidity. With the stock cooler removed, I discovered the board was bending because of the force of Intel's ILM design, an issue which I didn't even know could occur on 11.5X boards. I couldn't get good footage of it, but I suspect the raised square section behind the socket was added to support the board when installed in the case. The Noctua cooler didn't really add to the warping of the board, so it seems like it should be fine in the long run. I had already cleaned the old thermal paste off, so we can put a new blob of paste in the middle of the processor and then flip the motherboard onto the cooler. With the screw holes lined up, I screwed it in going from corner to corner, and then finally tightened the screws with a screwdriver. Finally, plug the fan in, and then reinstall the board and all the other parts, including the power supply, into the case. That's the install done, so now for the thermal comparison. Before we get to the test, it's important to keep in mind that this isn't going to be perfect. I had unfortunately forgotten that these systems included fan speed control in the BIOS, so for the stock cooler I left it on the default, which does cause the fans to speed up when the system is under load, and yes, I mean fans, but we'll get into that issue later. Once I had made the modification, which is permanent, and installed the Noctua cooler, I remembered the control was there and adjusted it, because the Noctua fan wasn't increasing in speed under load, so it's not the fairest of comparisons. We're keeping it simple and just using Cinebench R23 for this, as well as CPUID hardware monitor to measure the maximum processor temperature during each test. The processor in this system is a 65W TDP i5-6500, and all the tests were run with the case fully closed, as that's how these are normally used. Also, it's summer here right now, so the ambient temperature when testing was approximately 32 degrees Celsius, which is quite a lot warmer than it is in a lot of places right now. With the stock cooler, we saw a maximum of 72 degrees Celsius under a full load, and while that isn't too bad, we can definitely do better. With the Noctua NH-L9i, we saw a maximum of, again, 72 degrees Celsius. That seemed rather odd, and as I mentioned earlier, the Noctua fan wasn't increasing in speed when the system was under load, so the processor rapidly heated up, and there wasn't any airflow to remove that heat. With the Noctua fan at 50% speed in the BIOS, the maximum temperature decreased to 65 degrees, and with it set to 80%, it decreased to 61, which is an 11 degree decrease, and is more or less what I had expected initially. I know it's not a perfect test, since I didn't test the stock cooler with a controlled speed, but it is an improvement. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to go back and reinstall the stock cooler and rerun the test because I had permanently modified the case. There was, however, an issue I discovered with the manually controlled fan speeds, since the power supply fan is also controlled with the same setting. When I increased what I thought was just going to be the CPU fan speed, the power supply fan speed increased as well, making the system a whole lot louder. The power supply has more than just the 12-volt power connectors. It also has a third one on the right side of the motherboard that, amongst other things, connects the fan to the motherboard. There is a standard PWM header for the fan in the power supply, so a low noise adapter would completely fix the noise issue, which is a mod I'll likely do to my own system in the future. The system isn't perfect with the Noctua cooler though, because the complete lack of an intake or exhaust fan, as well as the extremely restrictive case, reduced the potential improvement. That became even more apparent when I tested the Noctua cooler again at 50% speed, but this time with the top panel off, and found the CPU temperature sat at only 59 degrees. There are a few other options for these systems if you're not going all out and completely replacing the cooler. Firstly, simply increasing the speed of the stock fan will help, even though it may end up being uncomfortably loud to be around. There's also the option of just swapping out the CPU fan for a better one, which would allow you to retain the original shroud as well, although it's important to note the original fan is only 80mm, and it's kind of a weird design. Alternatively, I have seen forum posts where people have reported success in installing a rear fan, either on the inside or outside of the case, to pull hot air away from the processor, which would add to the exhaust design of the stock shroud. Another fairly common mod for these is to cut a hole in the top of the case above the cooler using a hole saw, a mod which also works well for the mini systems. On top of that, you can use something like Noctua's foam ducting kit on the NH-L9i to ensure all of the air is being drawn in from the outside of the case. No matter what option you end up going with though, you're likely to see a fairly good improvement over the disappointing stock cooler. On top of that, the NH-L9i is becoming more readily available on the used market, to the point where I bought mine from Facebook Marketplace for $10, or $6.50. It's not in perfect condition, and didn't come with any accessories, but it was still a great deal. Overall, it's a pretty decent upgrade, even though the poor airflow through the case restricted the system thermally to a degree I hadn't quite expected. The thermal improvement of 11 degrees Celsius is excellent, but there is the trade-off of the system getting significantly louder as a result of the power supply fan. If you found this video useful, consider giving it a like and subscribing to the channel. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all next time.